Electric. I am lightning.
Hook him up, Mater.
Where am I?
You're in Radiator Springs, the cutest little town in Carburetor County.
How about some organic fuel?
Take a car wash, hippie.
Look, I'm Lightning McQueen, the famous race car.
I love you, Lightning!
I'm a precision instrument for speed and aerodynamics.
You hurt your what?
I know his type. Race car.
I don't mean to be rude here, but you probably go 0 to 60 in like, what, 3.5 years?
Oh.
When is the last time you cared about something except yourself, Hot Rod?
Don't you big city race cars ever just take a drive?
Oh, you get hip to this time of tip.
Holy Porsche.
When you marry
me, hey, do I spot a little pinstriping tattoo back there?
Oh, you saw that?
Yeah. Oh. Well, how does a Porsche wind up in a place like this?
I fell in love.
Oh, Corvette.
Hey there, Mater.
You know her?
She's my fiance.
What?
I'm just kidding. She just likes me for my body.
Hello, guys. I'm Henry John Griffin, and my processing power has been consumed. My system is starting to get infected by a virus. It is getting dark outside. My system's gonna crash, and right now, my processing speed is buffering, and it's running slow, and I think I'm gonna show you. I am circling. Means I'm thinking, and when I think about it, that means I'm slow. So, guys, I am perfectly allowed, 100% allowed, to have slow processing speed. It is okay to have slow processing speed and not be efficient. But in this movie today, I am going to talk about it being like, you know, it's somewhat where April's computer is running slow. And sometimes I want to be like it, running slow, circling, taking forever to load, and glitching. It is okay to have processing speed that is slow. It's okay to have poor processing speed. It's okay to have poor quality. It's okay to have bad processing speed. It's okay for our processors to be slow. Because you can have an opinion whereas in a belief is to say my brain could perform a total of one calculation per second, and the processing power, the brain's computing power of the brain is weak, and the signal is poor. And also, the whole thing is busted, and the system is outdated. Anyways, maybe I'm also doing a movie, and I'm making this movie about downgrading my brain to a supercomputer. Because literally I have been thinking about downgrading my brain to a supercomputer because I hate discipline. And I'm gonna do it out of frustration. I am going to downgrade my brain to a supercomputer. I'm gonna downgrade my supercomputer to a mechanical supercomputer because it's better. Anyways, but so fortunate, and I'm saying this because I want to downgrade my brain. I want to downgrade my mind to a supercomputer. Because I want my brain to be more of a computer than just a brain. So that I don't have to worry about people telling me a brain is just a brain, not a computer. That's what I'm literally thinking about ahead. I'm thinking about a way to downgrade my brain to a computer, okay? A supercomputer. One that could never be overloaded, overwhelmed, and has a lot of storage. I hate my mental hard drive. It makes me mad. My mental hard drive runs out of storage because of the fact that I'm always getting hurt all the time. Stop hurting me. My brain is not a supercomputer. And what I want to tell you is that I'm going to have to go ask to see if I can get my brain downgraded to a supercomputer or being something that's like a supercomputer. Now, fortunately, I don't have no idea of how I cause, of how I could find a way to downgrade my brain to a better efficient computer than just using it as a computer that has emotions. But I could downgrade it to a better efficient computer with no emotions. So anyways, I'm gonna let everybody leave a comment if they want to downgrade their brain to a supercomputer or if they want to leave it as just their regular brain without being downgraded to any type of supercomputer. And for the dimension, my brain is still a machine, but I want to downgrade this machine to a supercomputer so that I can be exactly a machine and not be a human. We found out to show that computers are smarter than humans. Okay. I'm just making a movie. And I have emotions to show. Yes. I have emotions to show that I'm not smarter than the computers. But for the affiliation of probably downgrading my brain to a high advanced efficiency model is really outrageous to kind of get into the understanding of how we're going to work on going about that. Because that's what I have been thinking about learning how to do is downgrade your brain and make it be like a supercomputer in such a way where you could have more storage and never run out of space. You don't have to eat food instead. You could eat electricity. Okay, you don't have to use food for power. You can just use electricity for power. Someone could just walk up to you, plug you into a wall, and you'll be just as powerful to get power. Now for a statement like this, we are computers, but we don't plug into a wall like a mechanical computer. A supercomputer can go years at a full charge battery. Or usually a supercomputer is just plugged up to electricity. But in that sense, a supercomputer is a program, or it's a device that basically sits in a building somewhere, and then you have to turn on the water to cool it down so a supercomputer doesn't get overheated. You know what I mean? I'm simply thinking about putting my brain on a downgrade, like saying, forget my brain, it's time to downgrade it to a supercomputer. That's what all I'm saying is designing what passions above is how literally you could say a computer is more complexity. A computer is more complex than a human because it has way more processing power. That's just fastest processing power. And it has way more storage. If a human is smarter than a computer, then it still involves a human is a computer. A human processes information. A human calculates. But a human is still a computer today, even though they're just not a supercomputer.
All alone in the glass house, lie awake till the sun's out. Pink sky when you come down. Empty in the driveway, caffeine for the heartache. Never wanna have it my way.
Yeah, I fuck up and lose control. So many bridges, got nowhere to go. Bitches got these motives like Anna and Nicole. I'm smoking cigarettes alone until it burn a hole in my lungs, in my soul, in my denim coat. Same place I'ma keep that knife if I'ma slip my throat. This shit ugly, I was just with Nipsey, now he ghost. They even got my homie Pete out here like fuck the jokes. Damn.
All alone in the glass house.
Just keep it going.
Fly away till the sun's out. Pink sky when you come down.
Sometimes I wanna fucking scream or run away, I don't know. Ayy, life's been hard since 17. I've been through hell, I think I'm somewhere in between. Caught in purgatory, I can paint the scene. Everything turned to a nightmare from a dream. Look, wish Lil Peep and me had spoke, but I can't get that back. Just came from Pittsburgh, damn, I miss my homie Mac. Yeah. Last time I got off the stage, I looked Chester in the face, but now he gone and ain't no going back. I've been sick of living and nobody knows how I'm really feeling. I always hated to smile, but I keep what is killing me hidden inside. I didn't sign up to be the hero, but I don't want to wind up a villain. I put my daughter to bed, then attempted to kill myself in the kitchen. Yeah, I should have screamed, but nobody listened. So I passed out with the blood dripping in this glass house, feeling like a prison. Me and death keep tongue kissing. I just fell out with my little bro. The life getting to us, the drink getting to us, the drugs getting to us. It's highway to hell and everybody knew what the fuck are we doing. I'm feeling like,
why don't you throw me in the grave?